you know that everybody that's involved in this, Alex Cora, AJ Hinch, Carlos Beltran, sooner or later, they're going to step out and start their redemption tour. So AJ Hinch was first and had an exclusive sit-down interview with Tom Verducci, and we'll have Tom on at 4 o'clock. And, you know, the answers were what the answers were. But if I'm the Yankees or if I'm a Yankee fan, this is the question and this is the answer that would stick with me. Tom Verducci asked AJ Hinch on the MLB Network, did you use buzzers?
We got investigated for 3 months, and the commissioner's office did as thorough an investigation as anyone could imagine was possible. I mean, I know he mentioned the emails and the texts and the messages, and I believed him.
Sorry, that's not good enough. There's one answer to that. We never use buzzers, ever. Not the commissioner's office investigator. Did you kill your wife? Well, the police didn't find anything. No, the answer is yes or no. Did you kill your wife? Well, the police officers, you know, they investigated. They didn't find anything. But did you kill your wife? Did you use buzzers or not? So to me, that answer right there, and you guys can rein me in if you think I'm wrong, that answer to me is proof positive that they use buzzers. Because this guy could have said, under no circumstances did we ever use buzzers. And he didn't say it. He had an opportunity to say it. He didn't say it. What does that tell you?
Well, that tells me they use buzzers. But the commissioner of baseball said they didn't find anything. You don't see that there's a problem there?
Yep.
I mean, this, if proven, can be one of the most heinous acts in the history of baseball, to have buzzers on players, and that leads to an American League championship. And I would think you get everybody upset. Right? You can't sit there and tell me, well, listen, Manfred's just protecting the owners, and the owners probably don't want to make a big deal out of this. Well, you know what? I would think the Steinbrenners, off the record, would say they're pretty ticked off they didn't get a chance to go to the World Series last year. They invest a lot of money with a chance to see if they can't win a championship, and a home run in Game 6 might have been hit because of having a buzzer on the player. You don't think that all the owners that lost to the Astros over the last few years aren't red hot? And the players walk away from both controversies with nothing. And I'm suspecting that sometime this week we're going to hear about the Red Sox. None of those players are going to get disciplined either. It'll just be Cora will be the linchpin, and he's already out of a job. So that'll probably be what comes of this investigation. This looks bad for baseball. It just does. Because this is a huge controversy, and all we got from the commissioner is we investigate, we found nothing. The thing they did find in 2017, no players get disciplined whatsoever. Come on. It's a joke.
It is a joke. It's a joke. And I thought that Adam Ottavino, when we had him on Friday, probably made the best statement. He said, when they got caught using the banging, hitting the trash cans, he said, they didn't stop cheating. He said, in all likelihood, they moved on to something else. And that something else is the buzzers. And
right.
That makes sense. Because obviously you do the banging because it works. Knowing what pitch is coming works. Doesn't mean you're going to hit 1,000, but your average will go up exponentially. So once that's taken away from you and you've got the algorithm, which the Wall Street Journal did an unbelievable job, that it started at the top, and boy, Jeff Luhnow is lying. I mean, he's just straight out. I didn't read to the bottom of the email where they said, anyway, that's another story for another day. It works. So they had the algorithm down to figure out the sequence of signs. So once you take away the banging, because everybody actually has figured it out, you don't just say, oh, okay, we're done. You go more high tech.
Right.
And that's the buzzer. And everybody, if you doubt me, and the only ones I think that would doubt me would be the Houston Astros fans who are just, you know, railing against the wind. Take a look at the face of Altuve when he rounded third base and he saw his teammates there at the end of Game 6. That was not, I'm embarrassed, my wife will get mad. That was, don't rip this jersey off, I've got buzzers on me. That's what that look said to me.
You said it clearly off the air, you just said it now, but that the point that I think is so strong is everyone in baseball believes that the buzzer thing would be a whole different level.
Yep.
Everyone has said that. If they did the buzzers, this is reinvestigate, pull, steal the... So my question to Michael's point, if everyone feels that way, why wouldn't Hinch go, let me just be clear and unequivocal. We did some things that are questionable. The league has investigated it, blah, blah, blah. I never want to hear anyone suggest a buzzer or some. That is disgusting. It's deplorable. We never. Why wouldn't you do that?
You know why? I'm going to tell you why. Because he's hanging by a thread on whether or not he's going to get into baseball again. So if, in fact, he comes out and says that, and then it's later proven that they do buzzers, he will never be in baseball again.
So he has to keep it vague.
He's got a little bit of a hedge now.
But the only way we can find out is if some former Astro decides to blow the whistle on the buzzers.
That's right.
But right now, it was investigated, and they didn't find anything. That's what Major League Baseball is saying. Now, here's a couple of questions. First one, what are they on to next? Because clearly they went from one way of doing it to now graduating to another way of doing it. So what are the Astros or anybody else that's cheating? What are they going to graduate to now? Now, the players also realize they can't be disciplined. So the Astros could decide to do something else next year. Just don't get any of the coaches or management involved. We'll just keep it amongst ourselves. They can't touch us. Now, you do some investigating, right? You talk to the players. We talk to the players. We've heard interviews with the players. Peter, you hit the nail on the head. The wiring, the buzzers, that's crossing a line, all right? That's got everybody up in arms. All the players are upset about this. So why couldn't Manfred go to Tony Clark and say, listen, your constituents are upset about this. You've got to let me discipline the players. You're protecting the few, but the many are going public to say that they're disgusted by this. So why isn't he working with Tony Clark to at least allow the Players Association to allow these players to be disciplined? Otherwise, what would stop them from trying to do something else? They pretty much have been admitted they can't be touched. They get caught in 17, no discipline for the players. It looks like they've been caught in 2019. The Players Association and, more importantly, Manfred says nothing's found about it. If I'm Altuve, what am I sitting there in the offseason? I better not do this again, or what are we going to move on to next? Because I can't be touched. I'm an untouchable.
Now, Tanaka today at Yankee camp in Tampa said he feels cheated about the 2017 World Series title. And the thing about that, with the banging and all that, the Yankees lost those two games, game 6 and 7 in Houston. I mean, the Astros didn't score a lot of runs. It was like 2-0, 1-0, I mean, 2-1. It was a low-scoring, well-pitched games. But after DJ LeMahieu hits the home run, that Altuve follows up and hits that home run, takes all the juice away. If the Yankees win that game, who's to say they won't win game 7? Think about that. So I think the buzzer is more egregious.
But here's the problem I have with CeCe or Tanaka or Urshela or anybody that feels like they got robbed of a championship. Then how do you explain what the Nationals did? Did the Astros stop cheating in the World Series? Did they stop using the buzzers in the World Series? You know, did the Nationals figure it out? But, like Ottavino said, hey, listen, we had a chance to beat them. We didn't. Even if they were using buzzers, we still had a chance to beat them, and we didn't.
Well,
so it kind of comes across a little bit as a sore loser because they have been beaten. Unless you're going to tell me the Astros said, all right, we pushed our luck in the League Championship Series. Let's not use it in the World Series. But if they used it in the World Series, the Nationals still beat them. So they were beatable.
They were beatable, and even if you use buzzers, Don, you've got to be able to somehow decipher their signs. So maybe the Nationals were much more careful with deciphering the signs. Now, remember, in 2019, the Yankees were suspicious of the whistling that was coming from the Astro dugout. So there was whistling as well as possible buzzers, and A.J. Hinch was at, if you remember, the whistling accusations were out there, and he went up on the podium, A.J. Hinch, and almost like made fun of the Yankees. Here's A.J. Hinch's answer to that question from Tom Verducci.
We had played a couple games against the Yankees, and the issue in question was dating back to like game one. So I knew a little bit about it going in, and it wasn't until we got to New York when I was getting asked the question.
The accusation was that you were getting signs and relaying by whistling to them.
And we weren't. When I sat at that podium, I'm going to defend this group of players, and that's my job. I didn't like the line of questioning. It was uncomfortable. I came out firm. It was talking about 2019, and we started getting investigated about 2017. I know it looks bad because it kind of gets blurry in the entire organization over the course of a few years. But I believed in what we were doing in 2019.
So he very strongly says we aren't doing anything with whistling. I mean, there's no doubt what that answer is. That's not true. That's why I defended it. He never had that kind of answer about the buzzer, ever. Ever. If I'm the Yankees, I'm red hot. If I'm Hal Steinbrenner, I'm on the phone with Manfred and go, this is a non-denial. This is not a denial. You have to open up the investigation again. My team got screwed out of going to the World Series. Doesn't mean we're going to win. We got screwed at least of a game 7. Sorry, this has to be investigated again.